Good morning again. So I have a blanket that's meaningful to me. And I know that sounds maybe like I have some kind of adult baby blanket, but no. It's not quite that. It's a unique blanket, and I'll ask my wife, Mary, to hold it up so that you all can see it. So this blanket was made for me by my aunt, Missy, and it's made up of pieces of clothing from my childhood. It's kind of like a snapshot of the many athletic teams and clubs that I was a part of as a kid. Swim teams, youth groups, Cub Scouts, Little League Baseball, church camps. I think even my first job as a bag boy at Safeway somehow made it onto this blanket. So this blanket contains a lot of meaningful memories for me. It reminds me of my childhood, and it kind of shows me the many influences that have helped me become who I am today. And sometimes when I fold up this blanket to put it away, I might notice that a piece of the blanket has become worn. And I think it's kind of sad, and I find myself having to accept that this blanket won't last forever. But then I pause and I think about all these little pieces of clothing that comprise the blanket. And you know, as I look at them today, I find that they don't have the same meaning to me that they used to. All of these memories, if I'm honest, they feel like they belong to a different lifetime. They feel so distant, so disconnected from who I am today. And really, they're not all that meaningful to me anymore. The thought that was put into the blanket itself is meaningful, but when I look at all these clubs and teams and things that I was involved with, they don't hold any depth of meaning for me today. So these things, the teams, the clubs, the camps, the activities, they did help me to become who I am. And yet, if I'm honest, they don't define who I am today. And it makes me think that we often want to focus on the past, sometimes even live in the past, don't we? The past has a unique aura to it, I think. It feels as though it's something that we shouldn't, can't let go of, because we hold on to it because what lies ahead is uncertain and unknown. The future makes us often feel anxious and even fearful. And this gospel passage today from the book of Luke, it too kind of speaks of those unknowns, those things in life, in the world, that feel inevitable, things that we can't control, wars, disasters, even pandemics. And then in verse 13, amidst all of those uncertainties, Jesus says something I think kind of odd. He said that all of these unknowns, all of those future things that could terrify us, they will give us an opportunity to testify. An opportunity to testify. Now, I know that Jesus was specifically speaking to his disciples around the temple in Jerusalem, and that these men, they looked at the temple as a place of security and constancy, this impenetrable building that they thought would never be taken down. They believed that they could depend on the temple as the place where God would always dwell. But what Jesus said to them still has something to say to us still today. This opportunity to testify is about living in the present moment, living in today, and looking ahead, not behind, with faith in God. And I have to believe that when Jesus says that all of the chaos and persecution and calamities of life will give those disciples an opportunity to testify, I believe that he's saying that that is how faith develops, That's how faith finds its footing. Now, I want to make a point that this opportunity to testify isn't about evangelizing, thank God. It's about the ability to believe, to stand firm when everything around us tempts us not to trust in God. An opportunity to testify when the world around us feels chaotic and like it's crumbling. That opportunity to testify is about standing firm and trusting God. So what seems easy to me is to testify to God's goodness, to praise God when everything is going well, when we evade illness, when we have an abundance, when we feel content and satisfied. But what about the times of discontent? What about those times? What about times of illness, times of loss, times of being exhausted and doubting, feeling empty? What kind of testimony do we give in those times? Well, it's my belief that faith is formed when we can face the uncertainties of life with courage and trust in God, when we can be bold enough to stand and speak in the face of suffering, in the face of doubt, in the face of despair. Again, it's easy to praise God in the good times, but it's faithful to praise God in the bad times. And I also think that some of the most vital times of transformation that God does within us happen in times of hopelessness, in those times when we hit rock bottom, when we have nothing else to cling to and nothing else to depend on, not a temple, not a faith community, not family, not a spouse, not a job, not money, but only God. When we can depend only on the security that is found in faith, that's when our faith can come alive. So while it's always tempting, I think, to cling to the past, to hold on to those things that we know, the things that feel safe, I don't believe that God wants us to cling to the past. I think we are called to live for today and to trust in the promises that only faith in a loving God can give. Now, we're about to enter that season of consumption, as I like to think of it. And it's so tempting, isn't it, to get caught up in it. I know it is for me, to get caught up in the consuming, the overeating, the shopping, the buying. And it's tempting, too, I think, to find fulfillment and security in all the material things that will be advertised to us. But don't be fooled, because it won't last. And one day, like all those memories on my blanket, all that we've clung to, all that we've been defined by, it won't seem to matter to us. It won't even matter. And so we need to live for today and to look ahead with faith. And sometimes that can be exciting, and sometimes that can be difficult. It can be hard to look ahead when we don't know what's ahead. And I think it's hard to trust that God will be with you in the trials and difficulties that tomorrow may bring. But God will be with you, just as God has always been. And so with that, I like to think of it this way. Let us praise God for the past. Let us thank God for today. And let us depend on God for tomorrow. Amen.
Sure by now, God, you would have reached down and wiped our tears away, stepped in and saved the day. But once again, I say amen, and it's still raining. But I as the thunder rolls. I barely hear you whisper through the rain. I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I'll raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away.